What is up guys, Sid here and welcome back to another video. In today's video I'm gonna show you 3 drills to improve your muscle up transition. So the transition is essential in learning the muscle up. So today I'm gonna show you 3 drills that I really like to do to improve the ring muscle up transition. And the first drill is Russian dips with support. So this drill can be done with boxes or on parallel bars. I would recommend to use parallel bars since they are more practical. But if you don't have access to that, you may use some boxes or whatever you have at your gym. So you want to go down far into a dip position, as far down as you can go. Then you want to lean back onto your forearms or onto your upper arms. It's going to be easier to do this on your forearms and it's going to be more difficult to do it on your upper arms. So based on the difficulty, choose the correct variation for you. One way to make the exercise easier is to lean back in the Russian dip, get a little bit of momentum and use that speed to get up through the concentric. And as you get stronger, you may use less and less momentum and mostly focus on using your strength. Once you feel that this exercise is starting to get a bit easier, you can start to elevate your feet to increase the difficulty. And the goal here is to have the feet elevated in the same height as the boxes that you are performing the Russian dips on. And this exercise is going to be very helpful in developing the strength that you need to complete the transition in the muscle up. I would recommend that you perform between 5 and 8 repetitions of this exercise. And once you can do between 5 and 8, you can increase the difficulty to match the reps with the difficulty so that it is an appropriate amount of reps with an appropriate amount of difficulty. So the second exercise is going to be a push-up transition on floor. So this is going to be quite similar to the Russian dip, except we're going to do it in a bit of a different way. So you're going to go into a push-up position. So you then want to go into the bottom position of the push-up. Then you want to proceed and get up on your toes, lean back onto your forearms, and then you want to go back into the bottom position of the push-up. And so that is going to be the transition. The key thing here is to simultaneously go up on your toes as you lean back onto your forearms. Also make sure not to stick your butt up, try to keep your butt down and maintain that hollow body position. And you can decide for yourself if you want to do the push-up again or if you just want to stay in the bottom position and just perform the transition. The last exercise is going to be a standing ring transition with support. So you're going to put the rings at a height so that you can stand in a dip position quite comfortably. You want to feel the pressure on the rings, so don't use too much support, only use as much as you need. You want this to be as much as a real muscle up as possible. Then you want to start to bring the rings forward. Start to lean back, go into the false grip, keep the rings close to the body, and then finish in the top position of a pull-up with a false grip. With the rings at the chest, close to the body, elbows tucked in a solid position. And then you want to get back into the bottom position of the dip, and that is one repetition. So key things here are rings forward, lean back, transition to the false grip, keep the rings close to the body, elbows tucked in, and only use as much support as you need. And as you get stronger, you can start to use less and less support with the feet and almost start to stand on your toes to make it more difficult. You can also move your feet more forward to increase the difficulty, since you're going to have to lean more backwards to get into a transition. You can also move your feet backwards to make the exercise easier, and you can move the feet forward to make the exercise more difficult. So guys, that was all for today's video. I hope you've enjoyed it. I haven't posted that many videos in the last couple of months because I've been very busy with work and some new projects. Also, don't forget to check out my new website for training programs, online coaching, and some new stuff. So I'll post a link in the description. And if you enjoyed the video, please hit the thumbs up button, subscribe if you want to see more videos, and please leave a comment down below what you thought of the video, and I will see you guys in the next one. Peace.